You are now tuned in to 710 Radio. We are the newest and hottest independent radio station in Colorado and on the internet. The fans named the station. With over 1 million visitors and over 10 million hits. Oh yeah, our website is going bananas. We are the newest and the hottest. This is 710 Radio, 24/7 radio. Stay tuned and tell a friend. The Dabber's Choice with hot shows 7 days a week.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we're here.
I just graduated from Cannabis University.
Ooh, a university man.
I learned all about the law.
Oh, you bad boy.
And I learned how to grow my own medicine all in one day.
All day?
I learned other things, too.
Cannabis University, teach me.
Call 303-886-7998 or go to CannabisUniversityInc.com.
What's up, my 710 radio listeners? Rick Wainwright here, and I want to tell you guys about a church that I am a member of and support fully. They're called Green Faith Ministries, NAC, and they are the nation's first and only state and federally approved the non-denominational cannabis church. They've been serving the community with cannabis-friendly church services, educational events, and outreach programs. We only grow with your support, and our services are fully funded through donations from patients, patrons, and community supporters like yourself. Green Faith Ministries is a branch of the Native American Church and is a religious charity organization. So I ask you to please support our work with a tax-deductible donation today at www.greenfaithministry.com. Because your faith with Green Faith Ministries is a match designed by the Creator.
TH Custom Promotions. That's right, TH Custom Promotions. Your promotional product headquarters. It's the home of the branding man. Quality custom products you can't find anywhere else. I'm talking about you can get wonderful trays. You can get papers with your name on them. You can get three-piece grinders, t-shirts and sweatshirts, apothecary jars, disposable lighters, caps and headwear. And you can get this all with the branding man at TH Custom Promos. That's TH Custom Promos, and you can find them at thcustompromos.com. That's thcustompromos.com. And tell them Can Olympic sent you. I'm different. Kingdom of Healing Show, featuring Kimberly Mateo, is a nationally certified naturopath, master herbalist, iridologist, nutritionist, and a holistic healer since 1977. She shares 35 years of knowledge and experience to listeners who are interested in learning and overcoming health challenges naturally. You can listen to Kimberly Mateo every Sunday from 1 to 4 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. That's right, you tuned in to the Kingdom of Healing Show with Kimberly Mateo.
Hi, welcome. Thank you for joining me today on Kingdom Healing. This is Kimberly Mateo. I'm a certified naturopath and master herbalist, and I started this journey into natural healing in 1977. For those seeking advice, it's my hope that 37 years' experience will help you or a loved one overcome your health challenges. You're listening to 710 Radio, 22.9 Mott, Denver, Colorado. This show, I want to talk about energy work and the Rife frequency generator, far infrared saunas and therapy, biophoton, and just the healing that occurs in your hands and how to transfer that energy and kind of works along the line of Reiki. And so the first thing I want to talk about is the Rife generator. And Royal Rife invented this this frequency generator. And a lot of people really don't have an idea as to what that really means. There's others that use the frequency generators to greatly improve their health. And there's others who do understand the fact that frequency generators have medical use, but, you know, they're simply not sure what, you know, how to present that. You know, there are doctors out there that are using Rife frequency generators. And, you know, this invention by Raymond Royal Rife, he was a scientist, and he first created the frequency generator, and he used it with treating and curing illnesses. Through his work, he learned that, you know, these organisms react to different frequencies. So every health problem, every virus, every bacteria, different abnormal cells in the body, they have their own frequencies. And he discovered by using this intense microscope and putting frequencies through that, he found that when he ended up with the frequencies of the actual pathogen, they would blow up. He just started using it in different cases and found that those bacteria and viruses that had their own biofrequencies or a pattern of oscillation, that by putting back to them their own frequencies, it overloaded them. And then this organism, literally, by delivering this frequency at an intense level, the bacteria and viruses and abnormal cells literally exploded. So by exploding these tiny little organisms, you know, this was a way to expose a variety of different bacterias to test this out and see how it would do. This machine, and there's plenty of them out there these days. In the early 80s, when I first heard about them, you couldn't touch one for, you know, under $20,000. And now, you know, you can pick one up, a good one, a good quality one that's going to hold those different frequencies. It's going to hold them. It's not going to lose them. They're not going to, come out of coating. And they come loaded, preloaded with a lot of different ailments. And so with that programming, you just go to that programming channel, and it delivers to the body the frequencies that are needed to start eradicating that from your body. So he tested the machine intensely, and he discovered that the impact and change in the bacteria also occurred with body environment. So, for instance, being able to change bacteria into a virus that caused cancer, he was also able to eradicate those abnormal cells by altering the environment of the body. I've also talked a lot about pH, and having your pH in balance at least 7 to 7.5, if you test that with a urine test stick, and you can just pick that up at any pharmacy and test that first urine in the morning, and it'll tell you what your pH is in. And if you're acidic, if you're below 7.0, your body is acidic. And infections, viruses, bacteria, all pathogens, they have an opportunity when your pH level is in an acid condition. And of course, then the farther, deeper acid condition that you're in, the worse it is. And a pH of 3.5 is death. So, you know, I've talked about this before. You know, these energy drinks, they come in at a pH of 2. So we really wonder, a lot of these people that have their trips to the ER, it has a lot to do with overconsumption of something that's bathing all your cells in a pH of 2. And so, yes, you're going to have reactions to that. So I'm a big promoter to alkaline water, and you can find out more about that if you want to send me an email. Kingdom of Healing for You at yahoo.com, and that's Kingdom of Healing, the number 4 and the letter U, at yahoo.com, and I'll be happy to send you some information about that. We're 70 to 90% water, actually, you know, when you stop and think about what the tissue is all made up of. And so that amount is really greater than the 70%. But when we're bathing all of that tissue in sugar and water that's acidic, most drinking water is about a 5, and so that's not good either. You need the alkaline water, and to cook in that as well, to change the terrain, the environment within the body. And if you bring that into pH balance, or just a little tiny bit, 8.5 would be awesome. And in that environment, pathogens cannot survive. So I want to talk a little bit more about Raymond Royal Rife, and he received a Nobel Peace Prize in 1962 for his work on the Rife generator, the Rife frequency generator. He's also been recognized by numerous publications that specialized in alternative medicine. And for his contributions, he was awarded the alternative Nobel Prize. He never adapted to the mainstream medical field. The theories behind Rife work are still embraced by a lot of people today, and those who believe in the curative power of the electromagnetic frequencies. And, you know, we all have an energy field around us. I can't see your energy, but there are people out there that can. And we find that in areas where there's illness, a particular organ involved, it's not uncommon for someone that, with Reiki, for instance, to run their hands over your body, and by holding your hands close to the body, a couple of inches above, you can feel the warmth coming from your body. When you come to an area where an organ is sick and not functioning the way it should be, you pick up a little cold patch there. And as you stand there and you hold your hands over that area, you transfer your energy to this weakened energy. It's really not hard to understand that concept. I mean, look at a hug. Everybody has hugged someone that they knew when they were giving them a hug. It's like, oh, wait a minute, I shouldn't have did this. You know, this person is not liking this at all. And, you know, you're in my space. And, you know, we've all had that feeling. And that is our energy field connecting with their energy field. And their energy field drains ours because of the negative feeling when you approach them with this love energy and you want to give them a bear hug and they're not into that at all, and they're like, oh my gosh, what are they going to do? I don't want this happening, and or maybe I don't really care too much for this person. I don't want them to touch me. And you pick up on that, and you feel that. So when you're holding your hands over people that are, you know, ill and not feeling well, it's if you hold that over there, pretty soon their comment within a few minutes is, you know, wow, where your hands are at, it feels really warm right there. And so that's your energy going into them. And it can actually be very exhausting work. You know, Reiki healers out there, wow, you know, when they're done with people, you know, if they've got a long day, they're pretty exhausted. And, you know, you just things that you can do to reground yourself. And you know, one really good way is you know, just walking around in the grass barefoot, you know, get in contact with the earth, and that will ground and balance our energy field. You know, and there's you know, marching in place, making sure that when your left knee comes up, your right hand, your right arm swings
right,
and then when the right knee comes up, the left arm swings out. And so marching in place for 15-20 seconds also puts your energy field back in balance.
Interesting.
Yeah, so the Rife machine, what's cool about that is they have where the one that I have, that I love it. You just it has the patches like the tin machines, like
okay.
A lot of people are familiar with those.
Sure.
And you just, you know, hook up the ends of, you know, just the plug-ins
uh-huh.
with the Rife machine, and you put that on each side of your navel.
Okay.
And put it on the abdominal area. And, you know, you can adjust how well you want to feel that pulsing. And it's and it does. It changes. It's different pulsations, frequencies that you feel go through you. And you know, you can adjust that so that if you're, you know, if you like the feeling, you can turn it all the way up. You know, you can turn it all the way down as well, and you still get the benefit of it. And there's also units out there where you know, you can put those patches on your feet, bottom of your feet, and you can also there's these stainless steel like bars that you can hold, one in each hand, and then have those frequencies go through the upper part of your body. So one thing that's really good is, you know, your lungs and heart and everything are upper part of the body and the brain, so you could do those programs that are you know, in there, loaded in there. You could do those for the upper part of the body if you had the handheld. You can do the patch on each side of the navel because you need the positive, negative. So you end up, so you've got a positive, negative current.
So now you've mentioned the TENS machine. Now, does when you turn this on, does it feel like the TENS machine?
Yes, it does. It feels kind of like a TENS machine because TENS is frequency also. And but they're, you know, they're using that. That's directed to the muscles. But you get that as well with the, you know, with the Rife as far as frequency.
Okay.
And, you know, so for there's things for muscle strains, muscle tears, you know, hernias, that help to stimulate that tissue to regenerate.
Because I know when I had broken my back. And they had tried to do the rehabilitation on me, and mm-hmm. they had tried to put those TENS machine on me, and oh my goodness, I would walk out of there crying though. Uh-huh. I mean, I would be begging them. I'm not gonna put that on me ever again. You know, just because mm-hmm. of how bad. But I mean, I know it was because I was injured, but I know that there's other injured people out there. So, mm-hmm. I mean. but if you can turn it down...
I don't know why they didn't if you were that uncomfortable. The therapist should have turned that down low, because you're still... Well, they do want the muscle moving. They want to trigger that muscle response and get it moving. Okay. So...
I was just wondering if it was like that or not.
I mean, it kind of feels like that, but you can feel a variety of different pulsations and patterns, and so you know when it's cycling and it's changing, you know, the frequencies that are going through you, because, you know, there's a variety of different levels of the frequencies that go through you.
Interesting.
You know, Royal Rife, he invented this. He was born in the very late 1800s, and he studied at Johns Hopkins University. He developed bioelectric medicine technology that a lot of that is still commonly used in the field of optics and electronics, radiochemistry, biochemistry, ballistics, aviation. He received 14 major awards and honors that were given on an honorary doctorate as well at the University of Heidelberg for his work. In the 30s is when he invented this super microscope. And it enabled him, you know, to see viruses in the microbes, virus-sized microbes that were invisible to the naked eye. And he could even see... He could not even be seen with an electron microscope. So unlike the electron microscope, the microbes remained alive. And he found that every microorganism had a mortal auxiliary rate. And that's at a point of which it will shatter or break when it's bombarded by sound waves. Kind of like, does everybody remember the commercial where Ella Fitzgerald, where she had the, you know, a wine goblet on a piano, and, you know, she hit that high note and shattered the glass. So that's what we're talking about here with frequency. And he discovered that microbes... that caused, or at a minimum, was deeply involved with a lot of the cancers. And once the frequencies for the cancer-linked microbes were identified, it was a simple step for him to test this discovery. And, of course, you know, the poor little mouse, you know, the mice, they're always the first ones to get tested on. And then it ended up moving into clinical treatment and doing clinical studies on it as well. And there was a lot of terminal cancer that was turned around. So in 1934, Royal Rife and a team of doctors and scientists from a lot of leading medical research facilities, they cured 16 out of 16 cancer patients using the frequency machine. So then over the next 4 years, the instruments and methods were refined. The clinical proof was extremely successful. It was painless cures from a variety of different abnormal cell activity and microcaused diseases, microbe. And a lot of these clinics that did the research were in the Los Angeles and San Diego area that documented this. So for energy medicine doctors, using a variety of different electronic approaches, this is really a unit that a lot of doctors that are open-minded and are applying nutrition and herbs and other modalities that are out there that are not mainstream, they are having very good success with this. You know, the... you know, there were some threats on his life and his family because of this invention. And, you know, that's been pretty common over the years with the free thinkers and the ones who think outside of the box. So one of the things, if you purchase a Rife frequency generator, the one of the things is that if you've had, you know, organ transplants or stem cell transplants, I would not recommend you using a frequency generator. If you're having defibrillators, you need to avoid it as well. Anybody with a pacemaker, it's really not advised to use the frequency generator. The other thing is, if you do have oxygen apparatus, you need to keep the frequency generator at least 20 feet from it because of the frequencies that are emitted from the unit. And, there are plenty of clinical studies out there on frequency generators and a lot of documentation of its effectiveness. The best way to get your best results with using it before you get starting using a Rife frequency generator or even a far infrared sauna, biophoton as well, you want to do some cleansing. So, kingdomofhealing.com, a lot of the products that I mentioned, you can, that is any place where you can buy them and get those products in your home and start taking them. The internal cleansing. So you want to do, some bowel cleansing. Food enzymes are things that is a product that is excellent to get the hydrochloric acid level up to where it needs to be in the stomach. And by adding other enzymes that enter into the small intestine, those help you to digest and assimilate your food and also any other nutrients that you're taking. And they help with the process of pulling all the nutrients out of the food so that the waste is then passed on to the large intestine and eliminated from the body. So, LBS2s, that's LBS Roman numeral 2, is an excellent product for opening the bowel and emptying, and part of a very good cleansing. All Cell Detox is a product that Dr. John Christopher received that in prayer. And he said he was woke up about 3-4 o'clock in the morning, and he'd been praying for a combination of herbs to take care of, a variety of different illnesses, and especially abnormal cell activity and growth. And so he woke up in the wee hours of the morning, and he said he always kept a pad and pen next to his bed on his nightstand. And as he started writing all those herbs down that were coming to him, he realized that those were immune-building herbs, and those were blood-cleansing herbs, and those were digestive herbs. And wow, a little bit in there for the system as far as, a good baseline of nutrition, because herbs are food. And, there's high nutrients that are delivered in herbs. So that product is called All Cell Detox, and it cleanses the blood in the lymphatic system, and it helps to boost the immune system, and it helps the bowel to eliminate, and it helps aiding digestion as well. So psyllium husks is an excellent way to get fiber into the digestive tract, and what happens there is that helps to absorb and, remove and soften the walls of the large intestine to remove any kind of a buildup there. But you have to make sure that, a couple of teaspoons of psyllium in, maybe your juicing. I always advocate organic juicing. You can add that to that and drink that down and keeping your water intake, preferably alkaline water, keeping that intake into, take your body weight, divide your weight in half, convert that half into ounces. And that's what you need for fluids a day to properly get things flushed out and move them through the system effectively, and to protect your kidneys. As the kidneys are filtering and processing all of that, you know, give the liver and the kidneys a break, you know, by having enough water to help to flush and move that stuff through. So you want to do some inner cleansing before you get started with this. You know, the other thing to be aware of is, you know, oxygen. You know, disease does not thrive in a highly oxygenated environment. So increasing oxygen therapy is, it is detrimental to cancer and other disease processes. So, you know, vitamin E attracts oxygen in the body. Alkaline water is actually, it's an antioxidant, and it does deliver more oxygen into the system. So alkaline water alone helps to oxygenate the system. And then hydration is so important. And by drinking alkaline water, your cells absorb more of that water, and then it's oxygenating the cell as well. So, you know, by hydrating the body with plenty of water, it helps, it does flush the waste from the body. It also promotes conductivity, you know, and permits more effective photon transmissions in the body. So 15 minutes prior to using Rife frequency generator, or even a far infrared sauna or the biophoton, you want to, you know, you want to make sure that you're well hydrated so that the body is able to start carrying off waste, picking it off, and working on getting rid of it. The pH factor, again, should be in at least at 7.5. That is really an ideal range. 7.0 is, you know, you're in range, but you're in the bottom of the range. The 8.0, 8.5, 8.5 would be the tops that you'd want to be. You don't want to be, you know, too high alkaline constantly, but you certainly absolutely do not want to be acidic. And, you know, a good thing to look at with your diet, 80% alkaline, 20% acid in the foods. So your alkaline foods or your vegetables, and, you know, lemons are high alkaline, pineapple are high alkaline. And then there's your acid, you know, there's your meat and your nuts, you know, things like that. But if you're eating meat, make sure that it's hormone-free, antibiotic-free, free-range grass-fed, and grass-fed on native grass that's never been crop-dusted. And we'll talk about more of that in the next show with cancer, breast cancer. But this, did you have a question? Oh,
nope, okay. Not yet.
You just kind of
not yet.
You were getting out yet.
Okay. No, it's interesting. I'm just staying here learning.
So the, you know, the thing with the Rife generator is, you know, nutrition. Nutrition is so important, that pH being in balance. And we need to remember, when the pH is in balance and we have a high enough alkaline diet going on, there's really, you know, disease does not have an opportunity, because disease doesn't live on a healthy cell. So we also need to remember that you can do a lot of really good things and, you know, drink alkaline water and eat a really good diet. And then if you have overwhelming stress in your life, stress creates, it's like the highest level of what creating acid in our body. So those who are under a lot of stress, it's really imperative that you eat as well as you can.
Oh, yeah.
And you know, alkaline water, because, you know, you're in just a constant cycle every day of keeping at bay your body going in to an acid condition where then pathogens have an opportunity to multiply. And before you know it, you're sick, and after you're done complaining long enough, you'll end up getting, you'll get a diagnosis once you're sick enough. That's when they'll diagnose it, and then, okay, then it all makes sense as to the symptoms that you had. But, you know, I want to go through some of these programmed settings, the protocol for the frequencies that you'll find in these units. And, you know, there's a program for carcinoma cancer, sarcoma cancer, remission and maintenance cancer, West Nile virus, cysts, SARS 1 and 2, liver cancer. If you feel an oncoming, if you've been exposed to someone with a cold or somebody with the flu, you can run that program so that it starts, those frequencies are going throughout your body, and anything that you've been recently exposed to is exploded. That was a little bit of a tongue twister there. Exposed and exploded. So, you know, there's a frequency for that. Hepatitis A, B, C, and D. Candida, which is yeast overgrowth or thrush. A lot of babies with cradle cap. That's candida, but you know, we wouldn't put the frequency generator on a, an infant, unless that infant was diagnosed with something catastrophic, then absolutely, you know, okay, you need to do everything you can do. And, you know, that cradle cap with an infant is candida overgrowth fungus. So best thing to do is to add a product like probiotic 11, and you can actually add a little bit of alkaline water or purified water, just about a half a drop or full on a capsule, open and empty a capsule, dissolve that down and then draw that up into the dropper, and then just put it in the side of the, you know, along the cheek and the gum of the infant, and you know, lightly squirt that out and get that good bacteria introduced into the digestive tract, so that the good bacteria that's out of balance has an opportunity to culture, colonize, and grow, and naturally get that Candida albicans, the fungus, under control in the digestive tract. And that's one of the big things that antibiotics kills off. You know, that's why you always want to do some therapy with good bacteria reintroduced when you've been doing antibiotics or, you know, sulfa drugs and all those prescriptions. So there's a frequency for the candida. There's a frequency for Lyme's disease. And you know, Rocky Mountain spotted fever. There's there's more than just the Rocky Mountain spotted fever and Lyme's disease that you can get from a tick. There are six or more different health crises, and this is very serious. It debilitates your life. It can also take your life. So there is a frequency for that. It's a frequency for fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue, Gulf War syndrome, herpes simplex, parasites, E. coli, roundworms, papillomavirus. You know, look at these people that are these young teenagers that are getting the Gardasil shot. And the side effects and the things that are happening. There's, if you're diagnosed with the human papillomavirus, there's a frequency in the Rife generator for that. Heavy metals, the aluminum, mercury, lead, those things like that, heavy metals, selenium, things that are in excess and toxic into the central nervous system. There is a frequency on that that will displace and destroy these heavy metals that are settled off throughout the tissue. There is a frequency to boost the immune system. There is a frequency for relaxation. There's an overall general health frequency, and it's advised really before you get started on zeroing in on what you may be having a problem with. It's really advised that you do the general health frequency, that particular program.
I have a question.
Okay.
Since you were talking about metals and stuff like that, like I've been having a lot of vets come to me lately,
mm-hmm.
and saying like they have shrapnel, and you know that it bothers them. Would that help? Kind of.
Well, the thing is with the shrapnel, there are, you know, around the all of the tissues surrounding where that's at is you know, leaching into their body.
Right, right.
Okay, so the frequency generator on the heavy metal detox frequency would be, what that would be so beneficial for, would be for the destroying of that particular...
The leaching part.
The leaching part, with a frequency that you know, the shrapnel is made up of. There's frequencies to all of that, and so the heavy metal frequency would protect the whole body and the surrounding tissue. Then there's things that you can use to get the body, you know, the brain knows what's going on in the body.
Right.
And a lot of times it can't complete the process on taking care of it unless you deliver the nutrients that it needs to function properly. Otherwise, the body goes into survival mode, and it has to take care of your very basic functions.
Right,
and so that supersedes having an excess to take care of healing a wound, you know, or, you know, maybe you've got a problem with your kidneys, and it's just they're not getting better. You're not giving your body the excess of nutrients, because you know when we're sick, we need 5 to 7, 10 times more nutrients than what the recommended daily allowance is. You know, the recommended daily allowance is enough to keep you breathing. It's not enough to put you over the top to have the extra nutrients that are needed for the body to repair and regenerate tissue.
Okay.
So, all cell detox, again, is a way of cleansing and eliminating toxins from the body so that you stop the process of what's called auto-intoxication. You know, you can get sick. You can literally get sick from your own body's lack of nutrients, lack of elimination, and the diet that you're eating. So, you know, that's called auto-intoxication, when all those chemical breakdowns take place in your body. And if you're not eliminating properly, then they're being reabsorbed into the tissue. And that brings your health down. So that's called auto-intoxication. That's from within yourself, okay?
Okay.
So, you know, all cell detox helps to take care of that. Then there's a product that we have called black ointment. And it's a drying salve. And, you know, you can put that on wherever you've got areas of anything that you can feel slightly under the surface, or you know, a little pressure there and you can feel something there. If you start applying a little bit of the black salve, that directly on what you want ultimately to be pulled out. And then cover that with a Band-Aid. And leave that on, you know. Put a nice little dab of that on there. And cover it up. And depending upon its size and how deep it is, it can take anywhere from a matter of hours to 4 to 5 days. And what it'll do is it'll draw it. It'll pull it. It'll bring it right up and out and expel it through the skin.
Wow.
So that's the black ointment. That's pretty amazing stuff. And then once that happens, right now on sale this week, and you can find that through kingdomofhealing.com, is the silver products, the nano silver. And there's the silver gel. So if you're dealing with something like that where you're trying to pull a cyst or shards of something that are left in your body out, that black ointment will draw that out of there.
Wow.
And then you use the silver shield gel and just put that over that area. It will help it to accelerate with healing, and it'll protect it from any type of infection to take place and develop. So, you know, the black ointment to pull it out, the silver gel to put on it once it's out, and I have seen some pretty interesting things come out of the body. And, you know, sometimes it leaves a pretty good size hole in where it came out of.
Oh, my goodness.
Depending upon how far up it's got to travel.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, and the brain knows what to do with everything. If it's also something that the brain doesn't want it's not going to be processed through the system. It's coding it, like abnormal cells and things that grow that protect themselves and cover themselves in a protein shield. So that as the immune system is cruising along, it identifies it as a protein, but hiding underneath that shield of that protein is the abnormal cell. So that the body kind of holds it at bay and won't let it go anywhere. And one way to get it out, if it's not going to process it through the bloodstream in the bowel. The body makes a way to exit it through the skin. So it's pretty interesting. So back to this with the Rife frequency generator. Takes care of, there's a frequency program for cirrhosis of the liver, parasite flukes, your lymph system. For the lymph system for detoxification. So, you know, lymph system problems, sore throats all the time, cyst tumors, a lot of times can have something to do, the cysts with the lymphatic system. Tumors can also be in the lymphatic system as well as, you know, throughout the body. But the lymphatic system is the bloodstream's sewage system.
Okay.
So toxins and stuff that come into the body and circulate into the bloodstream, the lymphatic system takes those and brings them into the lymphatic system to lessen the burden on the bloodstream. And, you know, we've got 10 to 12 pints of blood, but we have 45 pints of lymphatic fluid. So when that 45 pints of lymphatic fluid becomes accumulative over the years of all kinds of toxins, then, you know, we start getting these swellings and these lumps and bumps, and that's a sign right there immediately that your bloodstream is congested, and you more than likely are not eliminating the way that you should be. If you eat 3 meals a day, you need to eliminate 3 times a day. If you eat twice a day, you need to eliminate 2 times a day. You know, if you don't, do the math. Where are those meals? How many meals are you carrying around? Autopsies have proven. Autopsies where they take all the organs out and weigh them, they've proven. There's bowels, large intestines, that they weigh. that have weighed up to 45 pounds.
Wow.
What do you think's in it? So, you need to be eliminating. If you're not, you need to get those bowels opened up. You know, juicing. There's the psyllium husks. There's also the fiber combination, an oat bran fiber combination that is really well. Slippery elm. Very soothing, nourishing, very healing. Add that to the Nature's Harvest or the Love and Peas or organic juicing, you know, a smoothie. Add it into that and drink it down. There's also a frequency for staph and strep. There's this liver support, mold and fungus, prostate, liver issues, arthritis, vision and eye health. There's a general antiseptic. There's a frequency for anxiety. There's a dental one. Lyme co-infection. There's 6 different ones of them. There's pain relief for chronic pain. Just like, you know, I mentioned there was the fibromyalgia one and for arthritis. And there's the heliobacteria pylori. And that particular bacteria leads to a lot of the stomach problems that people have. And one of the bad things about taking all of those stomach acid neutralizers is, you know, 10, 15, 20 years of neutralizing the stomach acids, you're going to have an aimable problem with your stomach or your whole digestive tract. And you don't want a nameable problem with what eventually develops with that bacteria. So there's a frequency to kill the Helicobacter pylori, and it's H. pylori. And we've got a product that that also takes care of the H. pylori bacteria as well, and you can find that on that kingdomofhealing.com. There's a frequency for muscles, ligaments, tendons, stimulates healing, general injury. You know, and those are just some of the things that the frequencies that are put into there, so into that Rife generator. So I would really, for those of you who are dealing with chronic illness, I would very seriously, absolutely, highly recommend that you look into a Rife frequency generator and alkaline water machine. And we're down to not a whole lot of time left here. I want to go through here this far infrared saunas. There is a lot of research that's been done on them as well. There's been PubMed.gov has, there's countless of medical citations in there that regard far infrared and how amazing that it works. The far infrared, of course, it penetrates deep into the tissue, and it generates a sensation of warmth. It's the far infrared sauna rays set up, a healing with. There's certain. It brings up the temperature in the body, but it doesn't feel hot to the skin. It raises the temperature below the surface of the skin. And at a certain body temperature, I mean, the reason that we get fever, you know, usually there's fever, there's a bacteria, or there's a virus. And the reason that you're burning a fever is because your body is doing what it naturally needs to do, and that is create a fever to burn up the bacteria, the pathogen that the body's having a reaction to. So fevers, you know, in a lot of ways, fevers are good. And you just need to learn to work, you know, work with them. You know, you get them in a tepid bath. You know, you can't dehydrate being in a bathtub of water. But far infrared goes below the surface of the skin. And, you know, there's a variety of different products. You know, there's sleeping pads and heaters. There's the really cool portable sauna. I have one of those. I've given a couple of them away to people as well that were chronically ill and couldn't afford one. But, you know, you can find them now on the internet for around $150.
Wow.
And it's just a little portable one. And what's really cool is it folds down and it's kind of wide and flat, like maybe the size of like a, if you were carrying a one of those cloth slings with the handle.
Oh, okay.
Artwork, you know. And it loads in the trunk and it's easy to set up and it's portable. You can take it with you everywhere. I also have a big wooden two-man one as well. But, you know, you get sweating and it's just, you feel so much better with that. There's, let's see, far infrared devices that you can put over your microwave ovens to negate you being affected by the radiation. I'm not having a microwave. So I don't think anybody should have a microwave. God. Okay, there's been over 700,000 far infrared systems sold. So people are becoming more aware of it. You know, this is another thing that when I found out about far infrared saunas and things, that it was hard to find a lot of different products. Now there's a variety of different products. You can get them like a heating pad and lay on them. So people that are sick, very sick, you can just, they're good sized. And I found one on Amazon. And it, you know, it emits the far infrared waves. And you feel very warm laying on that. And it's very healing. And you can feel it throughout your body. And so that's something that is really, really good for people who are chronically ill to lay that down and have them laying on that in their bed, in a recliner. But it's good for arthritis. It's good for swollen, you know, joints and problems with your ligaments, muscles. So very, very healing. I want to go through some of, there's information on the internet that you can find on it. Far infrared expands the capillaries, and so it stimulates increased blood flow and regeneration, circulation, and oxygenation. It also alleviates breathing problems and congestion, so it's good for respiratory. I feel some respiratory stuff coming on.
And it is a season for that.
And it's a season for that, so you know, spend 15 minutes in that. It's you know, scientists in Japan have documented that far infrared treatments of clogged capillary vessels, and it dissolves hidden toxins in the body. It promotes the elimination of fats and chemicals and toxins, lactic acid, free fatty acids, subcutaneous fat that's associated with aging and fatigue, excess sodium that's in the body, you know, it's eliminated as well with far infrared. So it stimulates enzyme activity in the body, and far infrared emits photons, and photons help to release enzymes, and enzymes stimulate the macrophage activity in cleaning, in increasing the elimination of damaged and diseased tissue. Nitric oxide is released, which expands the capillaries and increases circulation. So, you know, from diabetes and hypertension, drug addiction, toxins, stroke, intestinal problems, cancers, memory problems, sepsis, as well. A lot of different pathogens have been taken care of with the use of a far infrared sauna. I would look that up. It's F-A-R and then infrared, I-N-F-R-A-R-E-D. And take a look at that as well with the Rife generators. Biophotons have to do with biophoton units. Those are also, you can find information on them as well. And that has to do with light therapy and moving the lymphatic system. You've been listening to Kingdom of Healing, and this is Kimberly Mateo, and that's all for the show today. Have a great day, and see you next time.